So what the heck is next? Freaking X-ray?
Well, not see. Actually, it's EUV or extreme ultraviolet, more energizing form of UV light with tighter wavelengths than
visible light. Anyway, sure enough, with the tighter wavelength, things do work. But yet again, more issues. This time, supposedly with the machines themselves that blast the EUV, unreliable. Not beam those tracks, carve those tracks out specifically where they should, so potentially calibration issues. This is pure speculation because we don't have access to those machines. But who knows? The fact is, it doesn't work. But wait, there's more! Since the machines aren't reliable enough, the way around them is to etch the wafers multiple times at lower resolution. That's a process called SAQP in this case, or self-aligned quadruple patterning. Basically, these UV machines etch the wafer in question four different times, each time adding a finer level of detail. But again, as you can imagine, you're increasing several types of failures, yields, and driving prices through the freaking roof. Now, a single etch, even a double etch, it's not super difficult at this point. In fact, 14 nanometers from Intel was all SAQP patterning. And sure, the yields weren't perfect at 14 nanometers either, they never were, but with added complexity, you have added risk, and it's hemorrhaging Intel's R&D department. Adding more layers of patterning, you're opening yourself up to more areas or problems. So it is problem after problem after problem for Team Blue, and the worst part about it is they're a one-man show. That's what they're really interested in. They're at the core of why they're struggling. They have not traditionally relied on other semiconductor manufacturers for any of these ventures, and it's this mentality that I think is partly to blame for their struggles. I mean, if TSMC can do it, right? Then Intel's certainly capable, but the two don't share intellectual property. Again, AFAIK. And in TSMC's case, Intel's struggles only equal money signs for TSMC, so why would you help unless you're forced to do something about that? TSMC is Taiwanese, Taiwan Semiconductor. And that, at least, is the general consensus on one, right? The double etching versus the quadruple pattern, and also back to the mobile, which has its own set of issues. Cobalt, so that's so weird. Behaviors to deal with on nanoscopic levels, and also the fact that they tell them to solve it for going on their own. That is not in fact, it's probably why Google Foundry skipped that generation altogether, that equivalent to the nanometer generation, and went straight to the 7 as well. Just like Intel was, and wanted a jump start on the race to the finest level of node precision, and ended up being limited by the technology. And that's a real